Summer school is a different learning opportunity for the children, a different teaching opportunity for the teachers. Because classes are smaller, there's a chance to work with a child as an individual, to help him explore where curiosity guides, to teach him to learn through exciting discovery. Because grades are unimportant and schedules are flexible, the pace of learning can be set by the learner, and there's time to reach through to a mind that will react only to warmth and friendliness. And there's time for activities that just can't be fitted in during the regular school term, like this performance of Brigadoon by a summer theater class. Each district summer program is planned locally by local educators to serve its own most urgent local needs. All this is part of the new promise to Jim. During the summer, they had built a new addition to his school. Using Title I money, they called it a diagnostic center. Jim will come to this new center, along with other children from many grades and many backgrounds. And the search for the cause of his problem begins. The important question, why? Why is Jim not learning as he should? In early years, learning is primarily a visual experience. But what distortion of perception is there when a figure that looks like this to the other children looks like this to one person in the class? At the Diagnostic Center, professional specialists will check Jim's visual perception thoroughly. If they discover this to be his learning handicap, remedial help will be available. In some districts, service clubs and the Department of Public Health accept the responsibility of making sure students can see clearly. But where no such help is available, Title I funds are offered to make sure no child is deprived of his educational opportunity. Learning is an audio experience too, but if the teacher sounds like this, and you don't realize the other children are hearing this,
can anyone tell us another crustacean?
No wonder a boy feels dumb in comparison. But here again is the fulfillment of the new promise to Jim. His hearing will be checked too, as they search for his disadvantage. In some Kentucky counties, local agencies are providing hearing aids for disadvantaged students once the need has been established. But where local help is not available, Title I is. But learning is an exchange of ideas, too. And this involves talking. But how willing is a child to talk when the words won't come out sounding like you want them to?
Perhaps Robin should have fed his rabbits before he went to school.